Hi everyone, let's revise linear programming problem today. I'll be covering one problem, explaining all the steps. Refer the playlist for more problems. Let's go through some basic terminologies. In any industry or any manufacturing company, right, main objective of the management is to maximize profit or minimize cost, right? That is their objective or purpose. That objective is called as objective function and it is denoted by Z. What is decision variables? There are certain parameters or certain resources that enable a particular business, right? It could be the products that they manufacture. It could be the fertilizers that they use in agriculture. It could be the machines that are used in the industries. So it can be anything. So all of these resources that directly impact the profit or cost are nothing but called as variables. They are denoted by XY, X1, Y1, and so on. Constraints. Now, there are limited resources, right? We don't have infinite amount of resources. For example, there are limited set of people, limited space. For example, an employee can work only for 8 hours per day. This is one constraint. Or the machine can run only for 12 hours per day. Or they can only manufacture certain amount of products. Or they can transport only certain amount of packages, right? Constraints are represented using linear inequalities such as this. That is, it's less than or greater than. Then we have feasible region. When we are plotting the graph and when we are shading the regions or shading the constraints, you have an overlapping region, right? That is called as feasible region. Feasible solution, all the values that satisfy these constraints. Now, to satisfy these constraints, there are certain variables, right? So all of that satisfy these constraints become the feasible solution. Optimal solution is a solution that gives the maximum or minimum value. That is, for example, the solution that gives the maximum profit or minimum cost becomes the optimal solution. Now, when you have constraints greater than or equal to, then the shading is going to be above the constraint line or away from the origin, like this, right? Here, if you observe, the constraints are greater than. You have two constraints and both are having greater than or equal to. So in this case, the shading is going to be above the line, away from the origin. So this becomes an unbounded region because there is no confinement of the region here. The region is not confined. It's not enclosed. If the constraints are less than or equal to, right, you have both the constraints. So you have two constraints. If both the constraints are having less than or equal to, that means it is inwards. The shading is inwards towards the origin. So this is how the feasible region will be. And do remember to include origin also as one of the points when you have a feasible region like this. When the feasible region is having all the constraints as less than or equal to. Then you can have constraints which is mixed. You can have one constraint with less than and one constraint with greater than. In such cases, it becomes bounded. That is, the feasible region is enclosed. It's somewhere in the middle, right? It does not include the origin, nor is it completely away from the origin. It is somewhere in the middle. It's enclosed in the middle. So this becomes a bounded region. These are the steps to formulate LPP and find the optimal solution. First is, we have to come up with objective function. That is to maximize profit or minimize cost. Then get the constraints. And then get the points for each constraint by putting x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, get the points. Then plot these points in the graph. Then you shade for each of the constraints, we'll have to shade the region, right? It can be above the line or below the line. So that shading we need to do. Then we need to find the overlapping region, right? Region where all of these constraints meet, right? Where there is maximum shading. That's the overlapping region. Then we'll have to get the corner points. That is, we need to get the edges of that particular region or the corners of that region. Then we have to substitute these corner points in the objective function that we got in step one. Once you substitute the corner points, you're going to get the value of Z. That is, you're going to get the maximum or minimum value. So let's take an example. There are two types of fertilizers, F1 and F2. F1 consists of 10% nitrogen and 6% phosphoric acid. And F2 consists of 5% nitrogen and 10% phosphoric acid. After testing the soil conditions, a farmer, Vaidya, finds that he needs at least 14 kg of nitrogen and 14 kg of phosphoric acid for the crop. If F1 costs rupees 6 per kg and F2 costs rupees 5 per kg, determine how much of each type of fertilizer should be used so that the nutrient requirements are met at a minimum cost. Solve graphically. So basically, there are two types of fertilizers, right? And each fertilizer is composed with nitrogen and phosphoric acid. So in fertilizer 1, there is 10% nitrogen and 6% phosphoric acid. In fertilizer 2, there is 5% nitrogen and 10% phosphoric acid. Now the farmer needs, right, if all the crops need to get its adequate nutrient requirements, then the crop will need 14 kgs of nitrogen and 14 kgs of phosphoric acid, right? So these are the variables. This amount of nitrogen and phosphoric acid is given, but the farmer doesn't know how much of fertilizer 1 he has to use and how much of fertilizer 2 he needs to buy, right? He doesn't know that. Should he buy 100 kgs of F1, 80 kgs of F2? He doesn't know what is the quantum, because his goal is to get this fertilizers at the least cost. Now, the cost is given. The fertilizer 1 costs 6 rupees per kg and fertilizer F2 costs 5 rupees per kg. The cost is given, right? The amount of composition of each of the fertilizers is also given. Now, based on all these parameters, we need to find how much of each fertilizer needs to be bought so that the cost incurred by the farmer will be the least, right? Now, first thing is we have to arrive at objective function. So, one way to find the objective function is go to the last sentence of the particular problem. Normally, all of the problems will have the objective function in the last sentence, normally. So just go and check for minimum cost or maximum profit. Just go check for that particular word. And they would have given the cost or profit, right, per unit in that particular sentence, right? So that cost would become the objective function. So you have 6 rupees per kg here and 5 rupees per kg. And the objective is to minimize cost. So now this cost is the parameter that is used in objective function. To find the minimum cost, we need to know the total cost. For that, we need to know the amount of fertilizer 1 and amount of fertilizer 2 that he needs to buy. Only then we will know the total cost. But we don't know exactly the number of kgs of fertilizer 1 and number of kgs of fertilizer 2. Right? That is what we have to figure out in this problem. So we assume there are x kgs of fertilizer 1 and y kgs of fertilizer 2. Cost per kg is given. So what will happen? For x kgs, it's going to be 6x. And for y kgs, it's going to be 5y. We add both of this. That's when we're going to get the total cost, right? Now we have arrived at objective function. Second step is to arrive at constraints, right? Now for constraints, we'll have to find the composition of fertilizer 1 and fertilizer 2, right? Other than the cost, the other parameters given here are nitrogen and phosphoric acid. So these become the parameters, or these become the variables for us, right? So we put nitrogen and phosphoric acid into different columns here, right? And we put the amount of nitrogen in fertilizer 1, which is 10%, and amount of phosphoric acid in fertilizer 1 is 6%. Similarly, for fertilizer 2, we put 5% and 4%, right? Now, it's also told that minimum, at least 14 kgs of nitrogen and 14 kgs of phosphoric acid is required, right? So that means minimum requirement of nitrogen is 14 kgs and phosphoric acid is 14 kgs. This is the minimum requirement. So how much ever fertilizer 1 you use or how much ever fertilizer 2 you use, ultimately the total amount of nitrogen should be minimum of 14 kgs. Similarly, total amount of phosphoric acid that gets into the crop should be 14 kgs. Now, here itself we'll form our constraints. This 10% is for 1 kg, right? This 10% of nitrogen, 6% of phosphoric acid is for 1 kg of fertilizer 1, right? So we assumed x kgs of fertilizer 1. So for x kgs, it would be into x, and y is, and for F2, we have assumed that there are y kgs. So it will be into y here, right? And now we will have to add this. We'll have to add this x and y. Remember, don't add like this. Add x and y always. Don't write x and x. X and y needs to be added. And then when you add, it should be minimum of 14 kgs. That is, it should be greater than or equal to 14 kgs. Minimum is 14 kgs. It can be more than 14 kgs. So constraint would be 10%. It's 10%. So I'll write it as 10 by 100 into x plus 5%, 5 by 100 into y should be greater than or equal to 14. This is one constraint. Second constraint would be 6 by 100 into x plus 10 by 100 into y greater than or equal to 14. So on solving this further, we'll get 2x plus 5 greater than or equal to 280. I've simplified it here. It's actually 10x plus 5y greater than or equal to 1400. By taking common factor, we're going to get 2x plus y greater than or equal to 280. Similarly, solving this equation further, we're going to get 3x plus 5y greater than or equal to 700. So we have two constraints. And we'll have to remember the third and fourth constraint, which is x greater than or equal to 0 and y greater than or equal to 0. Let's not forget this. So let's put these constraints, x and y, because fertilizers cannot be less than 0, right? There has to be some amount of fertilizers. So it's going to be x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0. The third step is to obtain the points. How do we obtain the points? Take first constraint, right? Put x is equal to 0. You substitute x is equal to 0 in this particular first constraint, you're going to get y. So the point is x is 0, y is 280. Similarly, we put y is equal to 0 in the same constraint. We substituted y as 0 and you're going to get x. So the point is going to be x is 140 and y is 0. So we've got first set of points, right, for first constraint. Now we'll go to the second constraint. We'll do the same thing and you're going to get point C and point D. So second set of constraint is obtained. Now we are going to plot the graph. So when you're going to plot the graph, take the scale of this particular graph in such a way that these points that we got, ABCD points that we got, we should be able to plot this in the graph. So we have 280, 140 here, right? So we'll have to draw the graph in such a way that we can go till 280 and we can plot 140, right? So next step is to plot the points in the graph. So we'll have to take both the constraints, constraint 1 and constraint 2, and plot them in the graph. So we take constraint 1, which is A and B are the points, plot them. Then constraint 2, C and D are the points, we plot them. And then we do the shading. Since both the constraints have greater than or equal to, right? Both the constraints are greater than or equal to. That means the shading is going to be above the constraint, above the line, away from the origin, right? It's going to be upwards. So we do the shading for both the constraints and then we identify the overlapping region. Region where you see both the lines crossing, right? This section is the overlapping region. So what is the corner points? It's going to be A, because here you see the overlapping, right? It starts from A. Then you have the intersecting point between both the constraints. This is the intersecting point. And here, this point, right? This corner point. Now, there are three points, A, E, and D. A, E, and D form the corner points. Now, in the graph, we will have to find out the intersecting point, right? Here, it's coming to close to 80 and 100. 180 is the point. Now, once we've got the corner points, we'll have to go to the seventh step, where we substitute these points in the objective function that we got in step 1. In step 1, we got this objective function. Put the values of x and y, right? The corner point values, we put it as x and y. And then we get, for each of the points, we get three solutions or three values. These three are called as feasible solutions, right? Now, whatever you've got here, 1400, 1400, all these three values are called as feasible solutions, right? Now, among the solutions, we'll have to find the minimum one, right? Because we have to get the minimum cost. So minimum one here is 1000, right? And it is happening at 180, right? So now we'll have to write the conclusion. So we'll have to write optimal solution, that is Z min, is at 180 and value is 1000, right? This is the minimum cost. This is minimum cost and it occurs at 100 kgs of fertilizer F1 and 80 kgs of fertilizer F2. So basically the question was to find out how many kgs of fertilizer F1 and how many kgs of fertilizer F2 needs to be bought so that the cost is minimum. Now, for students of class 12 and science students of PUC, this additional step has to be written, right? That is, you have to write minimum value is when 100 kgs of fertilizers of F1 and 80 kgs of fertilizer F2 is bought, right? And the minimum cost is rupees 1000. So, as part of revision, I have taken one problem and explained all the steps. We can go through a few more problems in the forthcoming videos. Thanks for watching.